My name is Henry, and the title of my thesis is a comparative study of process mining tools. Introduction. Process mining tools, they are for like business applications. We take in event logs and inputs, and then the output process model. The event logs are actually found in information systems like SAP, SAP, and other information systems. Analyzing the process model actually helps us to solve business process problems such as delays, bottlenecks, deviations, and performance checking, which assist in decision making in a business organization. And the goal of my thesis is to compare selected process mining tools, analyze their process techniques and the practical usability in order to assist my audience in choosing the process mining tool if the need arises. And in order to reach this goal, I broke down some tasks that will help me achieve this goal. So the first is to describe the concept of process mining, what process mining is, what process mining is all about, and what it can do. And the second task is to review state of the art process mining tools. There are about 22 process mining tools in the market today. And from literatures I reviewed and I also read, I got some criteria to compare these process mining tools and their functions and how they work. And to perform the comparative analysis of these tools. And finally, I also provided the checklist to assist my audience in case you want to get a process mining tool, you know what to look out for and what to observe. And literature review. To actually get materials for this thesis, I sourced material from Otus and using the e-resource library. I went to Springer and IEEE where I downloaded a lot of materials, about 70 books. Since process mining is an emerging discipline, I limited my search between 2015 and 2017. And the concept of process mining, as you can see, information systems, for example, SAP or SAP, they store event logs in tables in the system. So, and these event logs records transactions that were actually carried out in the organization, like business process, how jobs were transferred from hand to hand, and all the transactions that happened in the system. So, and then the process mining tool itself uses about three techniques, which is the discovery techniques, the conformance techniques, and the enhancement techniques. The discovery techniques has about four algorithms, which it uses to extract these event logs in the tables, which is stored in the system. And then when it now displays the events using the time as the model, and it is now presented as the process model, which we see, then this model are now analyzed for business decision making. That is how that is actually the concept of what process mining does.
Question there.
And the criteria I actually use in selecting these tools, I visited some sites and some forums, and I saw people talking about specific tools, how they are used in the industry and how popular they are in the industry. I also read literatures, which also helped me streamline the number of tools I actually focused on. And I also contacted some experts in the industry. They told me that if I really want to understand the concept of process mining and what it does, I should take a course in Coursera. There's actually a course, Process Mining Data Science in Action, in Coursera. From there, one of the vendors there was actually magnanimous enough to give us a live data on purchasing scenario, which I downloaded and used. So at the end of the day, I selected five tools, Disco, Mining, Celonis, PROM, and QPR. And the evaluation criteria I used in evaluating these tools were actually from my investigations and research in literatures. I came up with some criteria, and actually they are basically two, the practical usability and actually the functions that are supported in these two. So the functions are like discovery. Discovery is the process whereby the tool uses algorithm to discover business process in the event log. And conformance checking, it varies with the tools, but basically in literature, the way conformance checking is defined in literature is a replay. When this model is being discovered from the event log, the model has to be replayed on the event log to find out if they conform to each other. It is from that conformance checking that you now notice some deviations, which can actually detect fraud in systems. And resources, this resource is this not, the word is not really ambiguous, but it simply means actors, such as employees, which took part in the business process. But from literature, there are three significant columns you need to actually get an event log. These are the activity name, the time, and activity name and time and one other. But the resource is not a compulsory column that you actually use, but it's also a function that helps display the business process properly. And another functionality I consider is social networking. The social networking is the ability of these tools to plot a map of the employees, of the actors, how they transfer the job from hand to hand, and how they apply other, how the business actually went between offices from desk to desk. It's what social network, what networking does. And modeling notations. This function in some tools can be converted, can be fundamentally converted. While in some tools, like in a tool like Disco, Disco uses a fuzzy miner, an algorithm, to discover business process from the event log. The discover process is called a fuzzy model. The fuzzy model cannot be further converted. But some tools use other algorithms like heuristic miner and alpha algorithm to discover business process. And it is discovered in PetriNet, which can be further converted to BPMN. So, and the import and export format also varies from the tools. And these are the functionalities I actually use in evaluating the tools. And the process performance analysis, which basically measures time in different forms. And animation. So when some tools have the ability, when a process model is discovered, it can be replayed in real time. So you can see how the process goes and where bottleneck. When you replay, you see where the bottleneck actually occurs. You see the token piling up on a particular process and the delay. So you can it's a quick evaluation of what actually happened before you go further to evaluate it. This is the process mining tool and how the discover process is. I just a screenshot to show you like a real life example. Like you see what Celon is, these are the same data, but this is how Celon is discovered it. Disco, QPR, Mineit, and Prom. So now my evaluation, the evaluation matrix I use in actually analyzing the tools. I have been using these tools for some months now, maybe about 4 or 5 months. And so due to my experience of using the tools, I assigned a percentage weight to the three techniques of the tools, where I further broke down the top techniques. So this weight, and due to my experience of the tools, I also assigned a score. So I multiplied the percentage and the score to give me the weighted score of my evaluation of the tool. So this is a table showing my evaluation of these tools and the weight I assigned based on my experience of using the tool. So at the end of the day, I came up with a weighted score. So and to make it easy to understand, I plotted a graph to show the weighted score and which tools perform better based on that criteria. So evaluating the functionality based on my experience of the tool, I discovered that Prom actually has a lot of functions and in-depth analysis compared to these functionalities. So and I also use my own usability matrix of how practical these tools are. But I broke down this matrix into four criteria. The first is understandability, which means how easy the tool is to understand. And the second is learnability, which is the ability and the ability to learn the functions quickly. And operability, some tools have some self-explanatory messages that guide you on how to use the tools if you are doing something wrong and that. And attractiveness, some tools are actually very attractive and nice. You know, they have a good screen layout and color. Usability matrix of the tool. Using my earlier explanation or my principle, I also did an evaluation matrix using an assigned percentage and score. And I also got a weighted score, which I also showed in a graph. So, and after using the tool, I discovered that the disco is actually easy to use, very easy to use compared to other tools. Some tools, they have good functions, they measure well, but they are difficult to understand. You need to be an expert to be able to use them. So I also evaluated other functionalities like the process performance analysis. I evaluated this criteria by evaluated this function by using four criteria, so throughput time, delay, bottleneck, and duration. Throughput time is actually the allocated time to complete the business process for the organization. And then the delay is the difference between the duration and the throughput time. And bottleneck is the hindrance. When you use animations, you will see that when you replay animation, you see where the tokens are piling up, and that is the bottleneck which the company is looking for. Like in the case of a production facility, when there's a delay in production, you can the bottleneck actually helps you to see it quickly with the animation. And then duration is the total time taken to complete the business process, which is recorded in the transaction log. Okay, and also the explanation that applies earlier, I also measured the weighted score, which I assigned to the criteria, and calculated the weighted score and showed it in the graph. So from my graph, I could see that the tools, they are all actually basing their tools based on process performance analysis, the time measurement. Like maybe the organizations or their customers would like to, since they say time is money, to measure time. And they are almost equal from the graph. But at the end of the day, PROM also did better in process performance analysis because it has a lot of functions to measure. It has about 1,500 plugins you can use, and it's also open source. You can reconfigure it, add your own value, and get whatever value you want from it. And these tools, they have different differences, but there are some key differences that actually distribute their characteristics. So I came up with a key differentiator to actually distinguish the tools. So I used the color red to signify no, that function is not present, and yellow partially present, and green is yes. So I showed the table of the key differentiator. So the differentiators are performance checking, social networking, modeling mutation. For my table, it is obvious that a tool like Disco, which is easy to use, does not perform one of the cornerstones of process mining technique, which is performance checking. And it also does not perform social networking. Like I said earlier, there are three criteria that are compulsory to come up with an event log. Resource, which is the employee and actors who took part, are not actually a part of it. But in real life, if you must investigate a business process, one of the advantages of process mining is that it is objective. It does not require, it is not subjective like normal audit process. So if you cannot investigate the actors who took part in it, that is where, for me, it does not really add up to the value of the tool. So Disco does not perform social networking. And modeling notation, Disco uses a fuzzy miner, which converts the discovery process into a fuzzy model. So like in this department, we did some, we used the BPMN tools and some tools like that. So it kind of made me inclined to BPMN. So if my organization have been using that kind of notation, and then I'm using a tool like this, so I cannot convert my model to BPMN, it does not really go down well with me as a person. But a tool like PROM satisfies all these functionalities. So this is a table to show the difference. I also brought out a summary table to show my comparison. There are the licenses, the version, and the platform. Some of these tools, they are standalone desktop version. Some are integrated with Excel based on the access chart that was given to me. And also some of them are on clouds like Celonis. And this is a comparison to actually show just a summary, a quick summary to show my comparison of the tools. And the checklist. If the audience would like to consider a process menu tool for any investigation in the business process, there are certain things you must consider. You must consider the discovery capability of that tool. How does the tool discover? Because actually, this a lot of things goes into discovery. Because some algorithms, they cut out some informations, they see them as noise. While some algorithms actually evaluate everything and balance it using some four criteria to actually give you more information. And conformance checking functionality. To me, this conformance checking is important because in every organization, there is a tendency to commit fraud. So if your tool cannot use this kind of confirmation, it just measures time and delay of production and other fraud can easily go through in that organization. So if you must pick a tool, you should also take a look at if the tool has conformance checking functionalities. And support for resource option. That is, also check if the tool can help you in also plotting. There are some employees who actually hand their work over to their subordinates. They don't do their job. So if you should load up, impute an event log of that organization, you'll find out that some employees are actually not in the office. So this resource option gives you the opportunity because when an employee is logged into the system, they use their credentials. So you can actually plot a social networking map to find out how these tools were handed from employee to employee. And how friendly is data analysis? Some of the tools here, they are actually, you need a statistic background, or you need to have some level of computational background to be able to understand them. While some tools, it is easy to understand their data analysis. And the types of node notations that are supported in the applications. Some tools they are friendly. You can convert whatever model notations you have discovered. Some tools, it is just static, you cannot convert it. And the import and export format. Some tools, the notation that were discovered, you can export in PDF or any other format you want. And it's also good you also check out how the kind of format you want to use for your tool. And the type of perspective that are supported in the tool. My conclusion, the goal of my thesis was to compare selected process mining tools. And I was able to achieve this goal by seeking access rights from the vendors and also registering in Coursera. This aspect was not actually easy for me because I have to write a lot. Sometimes I don't get replies from the vendors, and sometimes I also get replies. So some of the vendors replied me and told me that I can actually use the tool because RTU is a partner institution. So they gave me access rights to use the tool in upload data and the rest. I also downloaded data from Coursera. And the tools that I evaluated, Disco, Celonis, Minit, and Prom, QPR. And I observed that a tool like Prom actually have more in-depth analysis compared to other tools, which are actually predisposed to measuring time. And I also created a quick comparison of the tools. I created a table to show the summary. And I also showed the evaluation matrix, which I introduced based on my experience of using the tools for months. And I believe that future research can be done in a tool like Disco. Disco is actually easy, it is attractive, but it lacks most of the cornerstones that are written about process mining in literatures, which would have been very, very good if a tool like that has that ability to do. Thank you.